Hello, this is Solar Business TV for the last time from InterSolar Munich 2018, and everything is almost dismantled. Everybody is outside, everybody left, but besides, you know, Solar Pioneers and Solar Business Club. So hello, guten Tag.
Guten Tag.
Hello, hello.
So, okay. It's very interesting story actually, because we are on the booth of Nur Technology, which is one of the babies of our Solar Business Club vision. So those two guys knew each other, you know, since long time, but actually they created the relationship, closer relationship during our Solar Business Club dinners, during Solar Gala, etc. And one of the ideas was to create company, common company with different technologies. And these are two guys who are initiating the process together with Jafar, the chairman of the company. So first I would like to ask Luan, you know, because Michael is very famous on Solar
Already,
Business
yes.
TV. Yes, exactly.
<I can
agree. laughs> So Luan, how did you come up with the idea of, you know, having Nur Solar Technology, Nur Technology, and why did you choose Dubai actually?
Yeah, basically Tomas, looking to the history from the solar and history from the renewable energies, and as well the trend from the power supply and from the customer side, I've been thinking actually for some time how to make all those interlinks.
Now let's speak with Michael. So Michael, you were the founder of the idea of H2H, that solar is not B2B, not B2C, but H2H, human to human. And is it actually the one of the reasons that you created this company as a, you know, H2H, which is human to human ideas?
It's definitely not only H2H, it's also B2B, but more interesting, or B2B2C, ultimately. But more important, I think, working for 20 years in big corporations and small corporations, we've seen it all. At the end of the day, you want to have a successful management team and organization by definitely linking ideas you would have. So and I think what we are doing in New Energy Group, which is basically a merger of Nur Solar Technology and LTI Re Energy, is exactly that. I think we have a very complete picture. We have a common understanding, as Luan is saying, what the industry needs, how the picture looks like, and actually you see it perhaps in the background. So and how to realize it, and yes, if you are bringing people together, bringing value stream elements together, this is a process where definitely you have to cooperate, to collaborate, to understand each other between cultures in a global market like we are doing here in solar.
So actually, like very often, there are questions, yeah? Why there is Solar Business Club? Why it's so important to meet, you know, each other during the gala, etc. And actually, this is the proof that it's not only just enjoying, yeah? Which is also enjoying is important, yeah? But it's also like, you know, making at the end of the day the true business, yes? Do you agree with this?
I agree with you, Tomas. Basically, I thought just a couple of days back, looking to all the marketing and media promotion in the solar industry, I also come to the solution for my own decision that you're basically doing a good job. And I even didn't see for the last 10 years someone who putting so much effort on making those things happen.
And this was not paid message, yeah? No, it was not paid message, yeah? It comes from your heart, yeah?
Yes, no, this is not, it's really, it's. I appreciate that. And of course, we are also committed to support this. So therefore, we also see our very niche value, which we can express ourselves about the complete solutions.
But I would like to ask you now, guys, because, okay, we made the first step. And also we made our first step with the industry, yes? But now the market will increase like this, yes? And from your perspective, yeah, because you are one of the founders of Solar Business Club, how do you see we should work together, not only like, you know, on the customer supplier basis, but more on the leadership within the club? What would be your recommendation and which should be the next steps? Maybe now Michael, yes?
I mean, Solar Business Club is perhaps a good example where you bring some people together that they definitely share visions and they can reach together more than in the individual companies. And that's on the corporate level and that's on a company and entrepreneurship level. I think it's not limited to that. I think it's very important to reach broader audience, reaching society. and get support also by policy makers.
And financial guys.
Financial guys, most definitely. So it all comes together anyway, and while the industry is more and more accepting that it's not enough to have a module and an inverter and someone else is taking care of the integration, and that's what we are doing, obviously. The integration, yeah. I'll give you an example of floating solar, yeah. Floating solar, now the time is ripe because you can manage the complexity of the different components, getting insurance on top of everything, yeah. But saying so, it's not limited to the manufacturers. And it's not a different, let's say, group which is making some frameworks in terms of politicians. And then there are other consumers. I think as the numbers are making it by themselves, it's also clear that we have to speed up. And speeding up is working in an environment where you can trust people, where you can work with people, where you can share different ideas, where you can challenge different ideas. And for that one, I found it very valuable in the last couple of years. And as Luan is saying, running into him, I mean, it's sharing same things, and but also having conflictual discussions, and then we're solving it in a way. And this is, I think, what is happening. To add on this, it's nothing only suppliers or only policymakers, and this was always the case. I think it's much more reaching the financial world, involving them, not only in putting some money somewhere and hoping it makes a return, but getting them much more involved in the process. And also the society, ultimately. I mean, we had great examples, I think, of the last black tie dinner, where people are standing up, where you perhaps know from television and everything, but make a statement which is so more meaningful if you give it in the right frame, which is speeding up this process, which is happening anyway.
Okay, and Luan, what would be your recommendation that we can sell more our ideas and, you know, to bring more, you know, really important people on the board?
I think overall I'm still satisfying myself a little bit to say to myself that solar, it's still a new industry. Somehow, for some companies, maybe even a little bit misleading industry. I think we need to get much closer together and also creating different interface within the companies and also within the different corporations. And of course, I think the best selling point still is to come up with top solution and solutions which basically everybody profit out of those solutions.
Okay, so as we are finishing really now, so I would like to ask you, do you still remember what we should do at the end of our interview? Thumbs up for solar.
Thumbs up for solar.
That was Solar Business TV from Intersolar Munich, together with two of the founders of Solar Business Club, Luan and Michael, who helped, you know, to get birth to the first baby of Solar Business Club, Nur Technology. Thank you so much. Thanks for watching.